this video, we're going to take a look at the problem that you can sometimes get when editing different takes together that didn't quite match. The sound may be different, they may have been recorded on different machines or in different locations. What we need to be able to do is to match those two takes together so the edit becomes seamless. So let's our exit. Hi there, it's Mike Thornton, and in this video I'm going to show you how we can use iZotope RX4 to help us with music editing, in this case classical music editing. We've got a situation where we've taken material from two different takes and they don't quite match. Let's take a listen. So you can both see and hear that the noise floor is different between the original and the, what I guess is a patch. But we can also see here that there is absolutely nothing up the top. And I suspect what's happened is this patch is from a secondary recorder, maybe not as high a sample rate, because there's nothing beyond just over 20k. So I suspect that this recording was 48k or 44.1k DAT or something of that order, and this one was a 96k recorder. And so we've got changes in the noise floor because of that, but we've also got a different noise floor in the patch than we have in the original. And so what we can do, we can use a selection of the tools from RX4 to help resolve all these problems. So the first thing I want to do is to denoise the patch because it is noisier. But the problem I've got is there is no clean noise. There are notes playing all the time. And I don't have access to some clean noise to get a noise profile. So I have to get a bit crafty. So looking at the waveform, this sort of zone around here, there's lots of gaps in between the harmonics. We can see the harmonics of the strings. Remember that the brighter the orange, the louder the sound is at that frequency. So what I can do is I can go in and pick up and create a partial noise profile from the gaps in between the harmonics. So what we need to do is we need to zoom in. So there's the beginning of the note. So if we zoom in now, and then we also zoom in vertically and we just scroll that down. So there's the top and we zoom in a little bit more vertically so we can start to see the gaps in between the harmonics. So the first thing I want to do is to make a selection at the top. So hold and use the square select tool. So I don't really want to go much further down than there for that one because we've got some harmonics here. Maybe we can pull it down just a little bit. But those harmonics run out around here, so I can put in an extra one. But of course, what I forgot to do there was to hold the shift key down, so I lost my first selection. So let's go back again. Let's pick up that selection and somewhere down there. Now hold the shift key down and notice how that we get the little extra plus button by the crosshairs. So now I can add that selection in, trim that up to join those if I can, and then go in between the harmonics and actually pick up effectively some of the noise in between some of these notes. I might not be able to get a complete noise profile, but just by going in between the individual harmonics, there's a nice clear area there. There's a nice clear area here. And of course, the bigger I can make the selection, both in time and frequency, without nibbling into the wanted audio, the better my noise profile will be. So let's just scroll up a little bit more. And there we are now, see a nice big section there. And we can go in around here, maybe in there as well. Now we've got a nice big selection here. And another one around here. We can go in there and keep adding, but remembering to keep holding down the plus button. Because the most infuriating thing is you get so far down the audio and you forget to hold the shift key down. And you have to start this detailed selection process. Let's just zoom in a little bit more so we can see the detail. But I can get in between all these individual notes and just try and pick up as much of the noise profile as possible. Now we're getting down to the 300 hertz mark. So again, there we can see another nice little hole. Nice big hole in there. Maybe we can pick that one up as well. Nice one in there. We can pick that up down there. Maybe just nudge that over. Hold the shift key down and some more. Whoops, just zoomed in and out. So let's just scroll up. So now we're right down at the bottom. So we can just one more at the end. So if we now just zoom out so we can see what we've got and we zoom out frequency wise. So we show the whole section. You can see that we've made a sort of patchwork of clear areas. So now we go into the denoise module. And what I want to do is I don't want to process this selection because I want to process the whole area, but I need to learn the profile. So before I lose this selection, we want spectral denoising in the manual mode, hit the learn button. So now what it's done is it's learned the profile, but as you can see, it said that it hasn't captured everything at all the frequencies. Do you want to complete it? Do you want to join up the dots? Yes, please. And also notice here that I'm using quite a lot of noisy reduction, but not very much tonal reduction, because again, it's the noise that I want to get rid of. So now I've got my noise profile from this patchwork. Now what I need to do is to select the area that I want to process. So we pick up the patch and we hit the process button. And it takes a few moments just to process through that clip using our assembled noise profile. And there we go. We've been able to denoise that process. So if I just go back, you can see how it's cleaned up that whole area. So that's the first stage. So the next thing I want to do is to try and just tidy up the top end here. So I'm going to actually use the spectral repair and just bring it down into the top of the audio on the patch. Now use spectral repair, but I'm going to use it with vertical. So it's looking top and bottom, using quite a high strength, and process that. Just watch what happens when it finishes processing. You can see now how we've been able to do a little bit of reconstruction of the high-end audio that was effectively never recorded. So that's helped there, but as you can see, we've got a lot of black. There's quite a few areas there with no audio, no noise, no ambience. So the next thing I'm going to do is to use the new ambience match feature in RX4 Advanced. So go into the Ambience Match plugin. And now what I want to do is get it to learn this profile. And then what I want to do now is I want to take that noise profile and fill out my problem area here. So now we're going to hit process, and it's going to fill in the ambience but leave the original audio in position. Now let's take a listen to that. Now that's pretty good. Now there's one thing that I'm noticing. I reckon the image width changes throughout the patch. So the last thing I'm going to do is to go into the channel ops and use the increased stereo width preset and just adjust that and then hit process, because the image width gets a little bit narrower in the patch. So if we just process that, and now we play that. And there we go. Job done.